It's the second evening session of swimming at the 30th Summer Universiade in Naples. And we've taken you to Piscina Scandoni, where spectators of all ages and experience have popped in here to have a look at this session, which will include five finals. So the lineup has the young Australian William Yang as the fastest qualifier. His 23.39 in the semi-finals earned him that position. Night two of the swimming. World Summer University Games being held in Naples. The fifth time the games have been held in Italy. Interesting to see the different final preparations that these young athletes take. Watch them, some standing with one leg on the starting block, some standing easy. Now they're all up into position. Starter knew they were ready, and there is silence for the start. That's good. They all hear the gun, they all head, they get go, and they're all away. The first of the finals on the second night of competition, the men's 50 meters butterfly. William Yang in lane four from Australia takes them out quickly, but he's not having it all his own way. On his right in lane five, it's going to be tight. They all hit the wall together. It is Yang. Tanaka, who was on his right, finishes in second place. And Pekarski of Belarus is the man who takes the bronze medal. 23.32, quicker than he did in the semi-finals. And it's been absolutely enough to give this Australian the first gold medal of night two. Yuya Tanaka of Niigata University. Grigori Pekarski from Belarus has the bronze medal. That was very tight between those two, Yang and Tanaka. And the times show at that too, 3/100ths of a second separating Yang and Tanaka. Pekarski in third place. The first final tonight. Final of the men's 100 backstroke. That's our next event. Justin Ress was really outstanding at that time, 53.47. Tarasevich of the Russian Federation, 53.71. The only two to go under 54. He swam very impressive 53.47 yesterday. So Ress in lane four from the USA. To his left in lane five, Tarasevich. Then Mefford, Fantoni, and Bassetto. And to Ress's right in lane three is Waddell. Then the Frenchman, Ndoye Brouard, and Nikolaev in lane one. How the Russian swimmer Tarasevich went up very high. His forehead was almost touching the platform. He gets away very well, but a better start on his left came from Ress. So Justin Ress They're in a line. No one breaking out. Lane three, that's Waddell. He turns quickly and just behind rest. What's his breakout like? It's pretty good. In fact, Waddell looks in very promising situation here. He's up against one of the hot shots, Justin Ress of the USA. But there are other challenges, but it's Waddell and Ress. Waddell and Ress, lane five. Teresovic up there as well. And Teresovic, oh my word, Teresovic. Those final 25 meters. Suddenly the big, tall Russian stretches through and takes it, and there's joy down in lane two, because right out of my shot and sight was Johan Ndoye Brouard. There he goes. You see his reaction now. He gets in second place. No, that was his lane. He got third, I'm sure. No, he does get second. 53.81 was the time for Justin Ress. That's way outside what he's capable of. So this is an upset here with Grigory Teresovic. Yeah. 27.53 his last 50. 27.32 for the Frenchman. And 27.54 Nikolaev. Waddell was in there, 53.87, but finished in fourth place. To the action now, the next of the finals on night two of competition, the women's equivalent of the medal ceremony we've just seen. It's a women's 50 meter butterfly final from the Russian Federation, the Netherlands, two from Korea, two from Japan, South Africa, and Chinese Taipei. Had that wait in the waiting room, listening to music, clearing their heads, going through their mental and last physical preparation once they're out of the pool. And now they listen as the crowd silences and waits for the call. They were silent for a moment. Now they are. Bodarenko here in the black and lane one from the Russian Federation. Out in the middle, though, we'll be looking at the Koreans and the Japanese, and also Lovemore of South Africa. Over in lane six, it is Lovemore who's making an impression. Come back in a couple of lanes to Xiong in lane four. Lovemore's attacking still, holding it in lane six. Now they come at her in lanes four and five, and it is Xiong who gets up in lane four. Soma in lane five, Lovemore. Oh, Lovemore has got it in lane six. She has. That was a stunning result for her, and she is very emotional about this. She looked to have it, with about 10 to go, the rest closed. One of the Koreans and the Japanese, one of the Japanese closed it. Soma getting up for second. Thank goodness for electronic timing, eh? Watching that, it really looked as though Soma had got in for it. Jiong and Lovemore. But look at that, 1, 2, and 3. Lovemore, Soma, Jiong. Taylor Lovemore, 26.25. She did a 26.6 in the semi-finals. I think that's a personal best for her. Very impressive. The reaction time was the best. There it is confirmed. The winner of the women's 50 meters butterfly is South African's Taylor Lovemore, who goes to Florida State University. Ai Soma of Japan will take the silver medal. And the third place goes to Jong Soon of South Korea. Wonderful race. Next of our races, another of the five finals we have tonight. It's the men's 100 breaststroke. Well, what can Ian Finity do? And I mention him because he set a new games record. But we'll look at them as they come out to their respective lanes. In lane one, it's Théo Bussière from Aix-Marseille University in France. Prigoda of the Russian Federation from St. Petersburg State University. And he has form. Don't rule him out at all of this particular race, the 100 breaststroke. Nor this man either, Craig Benson. Attends Stirling University in Scotland, representing the Great Britain team here. He's in lane number two. Yuya Hinomoto, Kindai University, 22 years of age. Now, if any nation, great breaststroking nation, Japan, have produced some of the history's greatest breaststrokers. And Hinomoto will be lining up in lane six. We've just seen coming out Sidlauskas of Lithuania, who's in lane three. And lane five, Mike Hooley of South Africa. He was over the moon at his performance in the semi-finals. He attends Tennessee State University. And the man who cracked on the pace last night, Ian Finity, his 59.51, was a personal best. It's a new games record here. It was his first sub-60 second time, as it was for the man in lane five, Mike Hooley of South Africa. Both going under 60 seconds for the first time. And Finity, a 59.51. We've already seen tonight in the finals, though, that being the fastest qualifier for the final does not guarantee you anything. So there we are, Bussière, Benson, Sidlauskas, Finity, Hooley, Hinomoto, Prigoda, and Ogretir of Turkey in lane eight. Well, Hooley looks to be totally relaxed. It was a great thrill for him last night. He showed every sort of emotion, most of it joy. They're set. They've been called in the men's 100 breaststroke final. All have very good starts, as you'd expect. Strong work underneath the big last pull brings them out into the surface, and they're working. 25 meters gone. Hooley looks good. Hinamoto of Japan also. And over in lane seven, Prigoda of St. Petersburg State University in the Russian Federation. Now it is Hooley. Hooley and alongside him, Finity. Who goes first? Hooley. Finity second. Prigoda out in lane seven in third place. Great turn there and excellent underwater effort and technique from Infinity. Wow, Hooley and Finity. Look at that game's line. That's the record line. Finity holds that. Finity and Hooley. Finity looks to have a slight edge. It'll all depend on the touch. Prigoda is out in lane seven in third place. They come to the wall, and it is Finity. Prigoda snatches second ahead of Hinamoto, and Hooley just faded briefly over that last 5 meters and was touched out. Another game's record. Infinity, 59.49, a personal best and a game's record, and he needed to do it, because there was some pace in that race. Finity in lane four. The big Russian, here he is, Kirill Prigoda. He got up for second. His time was a 59.5. And Hinamoto, as we saw in the semifinals, his finishing is outstanding. He snuck up in the heat. He snuck up in his semi-final with very fast finishing. And his second 50 was 31.41, the fastest by some margin. It was good enough, too, to get him the bronze medal. Finity of the USA, Prigoda of the Russian Federation, and Hinamoto of Japan, 1, 2, and 3 in the men's 100 breaststroke. Back to the action and another of the finals. It's the last of the finals tonight. The women's 200 meters backstroke. I know there's one family that'll be very on edge here tonight. It's Lisa Bratton's family, staying in the same accommodation as I am, and had a chat to them yesterday. They're really enthusiastic and hopeful, of course, that Lisa will do something special here tonight. Second fastest qualifier, swimming in lane five. Backstroke 200 meters. It's the women's final on night two of competition. In lane four, it's Sight. She has a black cap just in front of the rest. Is it a bit deceptive, or do we see Furubayashi over there in lane eight swimming comfortably as well? She might turn in third place behind Sight and Bratton and Furubayashi. It's 200 meters. Sight wearing the red. Sight still holds that advantage, but it's negligible now as Bratton comes into the picture. Still up at the top there, Furubayashi, a threat at the moment. Great control, nice form, both of them turning exceptionally well, and off the wall it'll come Sight and Bratton. And a very good turn by sight. Both keeping those heads nice and still, staring up at the ceiling, but well aware of what's happening, the splash and the sound and the knowledge of what the other one is capable of. And watch Bratton now. That's a move from her. Coming to the wall with 50 to go. It'll still be sight. They turn. Underwater work is brilliant. Bratton first into the stroke. Maybe a slight edge underwater for sight. Nothing in it between these two. 25 to go, the two Americans. Closest to us there, Asia Sight of Kentucky University. Inside the game's record, which she set last night. Bratton has just got an edge now. Bratton and Sight, the two Americans. Bratton has timed this well and goes to the wall with a new game's record. A champion at 200 meters backstroke, Lisa Bratton. That's a personal best for her, and she needed to do it, 207.91. That's a very good time for this young woman. Asia Sight, early leader, even at the wall with 50 to go. She was in that race for gold. At the end, she was still in the race for gold. But it eluded her, has gone to Lisa Bratton of the USA, Sight second, and Chloe Golding of Great Britain moved in for third place and the bronze medal. Games record, 207.91, personal best as well. Personal best for Sight at 208.56 at the same time, bettering the previous record that she held, Golding at 209.57. Great battle between the two Americans. Thank you.